Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Saturday, SpaceX successfully launched their 65th mission of the year, Starlink 616 on a Falcon 9 rocket.
One, ignition, engine full power, and liftoff of Starlink 616. Go Starlink, go Falcon.
The booster which launched this mission, B1078, then landed successfully for the fifth time on the drone ship. Just read the instructions.
Landing leg deploy. Stage 1 landing confirmed.
Coming up this week, we can hopefully expect to see another couple of Starlink missions launch. The first of these, the Starlink 617 mission, is currently scheduled for Wednesday 20th at 1:47 a.m. UTC or Tuesday 19th at 9:45 p.m. EDT. Then, a bit later in the week, we could expect to see another launch. The Starlink 73 mission is currently scheduled for Saturday 23rd at 12:31 a.m. UTC or Friday 22nd at 8:31 p.m. EDT. There was some Starlink information that was posted recently. It says Starlink's first community gateway is providing gigabit connectivity up to 10 gigabits per second today on the remote island of Unalaska, Alaska. There was some more Starlink-related information posted. It says developed in-house the dielectric mirrors on the surface of the satellites in extremely dark black paint for angled surfaces or those not conducive to mirror adhesion help absorb and redirect light away from the ground. There was an article posted related to Starlink antenna costs. It says SpaceX is no longer absorbing the cost of the Starlink antennas it sells with its satellite internet service, a company executive said Wednesday, a key step to the company improving its profitability. Heading to Boca Chica, here's a view of the launch site. In the production yard, the work on expanding the Star Factory production building is continuing. SpaceX posted this really cool picture of the team at Starbase beneath the fully stacked vehicle that will fly next. They said, made on Earth by humans. SpaceX posted a couple of cool videos of Raptor engine firings. The first of these says, test of a Raptor vacuum engine chilled to mimic conditions after a long coast period in space. They responded to this by posting another Raptor firing video. This one says Raptor engine demonstration of a descent burn to the lunar surface. SpaceX also posted some cool pictures of the fully stacked Starship and Super Heavy vehicles. They said Starship represents a fully reusable transportation system designed to carry both crew and cargo to Earth orbit, the Moon, Mars and beyond. There is information related to when we could see the FAA modify the launch license to allow Flight 2 to happen. This article says the acting head of the Federal Aviation Administration said on Wednesday the agency could advance a launch license as early as next month for the SpaceX Starship rocket. Interestingly, recently Ship 20's lifting points have been filled with heat shield tiles. The Ship 31 common dome section was seen moved in the yard. Booster 10 was recently lifted onto the booster thrust simulator in the megabay. Booster 10 was also rolled out of the megabay over to Massey's for some testing. With Booster 10 rolled out, Booster 11 was spotted moving to the megabay. There was some Booster 13 stacking seen going on in the megabay as well. To finish up the video, I wanted to share a couple of temporary road closures on the Cameron County website. These closures are for tomorrow, Monday 18th and Tuesday 19th. As always, I have to say thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.